Hello everyone, welcome back to my YouTube channel, it's me Toppy, and for today's vlog I'm going to give you some mnemonics and are you going to memorize whether it's written in alphabet, three trees, the letters or in and letters from mentors. Welcome back to my YouTube channel, it's me Tala P, and for today's vlog I'm going to give you some mnemonics on how are you going to classify whether a certain enterobacteriaceae is a lactose or a non-lactose fermenters. So the mnemonic for those that are non-lactose fermenters, you remember this: Edward loves to drink Pepsi but with no sugar. There's no sugar, I am referring to those that are non-lactose fermenters. Whenever Edward is drinking this Pepsi that is not P-E-P-S-I, but rather P-E-P-S-S-Y, you'll know why later why this is the acronym for the Pepsi. Whenever he drinks that Pepsi that has no sugar, he would say, Pepsi. So this Pepsi, we are referring to those enterobacteriaceae that are non-lactose fermenters. And by the way, basically, these non-lactose fermenters, they are being determined with the use of what culture media? We use the McConkey agar to know if these organisms are producing lactose or not producing lactose. So what is the color they produced if they are non-lactose fermenters? They are usually colorless. So you remember that Pepsi, these colorless organisms under the McConkey agar, they do not produce lactose. Therefore, they are non-lactose fermenters. So this Pepsi I am referring to, it's Hafnia, Morganella, Proteus, Edwardsella, Providentia, Salmonella, Shigella, and Yersinia. So you remember, Edward loves to drink Pepsi both with no sugar, and he would say after drinking this Pepsi, Pepsi. Hafnia, Morganella, Proteus, Edwardsella, Providentia, Salmonella, Shigella, and Yersinia. Faster! Pepsi. Hafnia, Morganella, Proteus, Edwardsella, Providentia, Salmonella, Shigella, and Yersinia. So these are the enterobacteriaceae that are non-lactose fermenters under the McConkey agar that produces no color. They produce colorless colonies. You remember? Pepsi. Additional to the McConkey agar, another culture media that will help differentiate these non-lactose fermenting enterobacteriaceae is the Heya. Heya, it means hecton enteric agar. The non-lactose fermenting enterobacteriaceae that will stand out in this hecton enteric agar is the Salmonella Shigella organism. Because the Salmonella Shigella bacteria, they will produce green colonies in the hecton enteric agar. Another is we have this Yersinia, which produces pink or salmon colonies. And then the rest, that of the Hafnia, Morganella, Providentia, Edwardsella, and Proteus, they are colorless colonies under this agar. Another culture media that is used in differentiating this non-lactose fermenting enterobacteriaceae is the XLD agar. XLD, it means xylose lysine desoxycholate agar. Again, we have this xylose lysine desoxycholate agar. For this Hafnia, they usually produces red or yellow colonies. Again, red or yellow colonies 4, Hafnia. Red or colorless, 4, Morganella. Red or colorless, 4, Morganella. For Edwardsella, it usually produces either red, yellow, colorless colonies for the XLD agar. And additional for the characteristic of this Edwardsella, under this XLD agar, they produces black center, with or without black center. And what is the meaning of this production of that blackening in the medium? It means that if there is no blackening in the media, it means they do not produce hydrogen sulfide. If there is blackening in the medium, it means that they are producers of hydrogen sulfide. So you remember for Edwardsella, it usually possesses all the color that a non-lactose fermenting enterobacter shape possesses. It's either red, yellow, or colorless in the XLD with or without black center. For that of the Providentia, it's usually yellow or colorless. Yellow or colorless for that Providentia. And that Salmonella, it's usually red colonies with black center. Meaning the Salmonella, they also produce hydrogen sulfide. So they are producers for that H2S. It's color red with black center. And that of the Shigella, they usually do not produce color of the colonies. It's colorless. And that of the Yersinia, it's also yellow or colorless, like Proteus and Providentia. So yellow or colorless colonies for the XLD agar, what are the non-lactose fermenting enterobacter shape? We have that Proteus, Providentia, and Yersinia. So again, you remember this, Pepsi. They are not producing lactose, or they are not fermenting lactose. And also, you remember their color that they produce under the Heia, which is the one that will stand out. We have the Salmonella and Shigella, and that of the Yersinia. Green colonies for the Salmonella and Shigella, pink or salmon for the Yersinia. And another culture media for that non-lactose fermenting organism, we have that xylose, lysine, desoxycholate agar. So that's it. Pepsi. You remember that. Edward loves to drink Pepsi that has no sugar.
A few moments later.
And for the mnemonic of the lactose fermenting enterobacter shea, you remember kiss on cheeks. Whenever someone kisses you on cheeks, it's very sweet. So you remember that this kiss on cheeks are those enterobacter shea that are lactose fermenters, kiss on cheeks. But the K-I-S-S, it is not the mnemonic, but it's rather K-E-E-S and then letter C. Kiss on cheeks. K-E-E-S, letter C. Kiss on cheeks, this lactose fermenting enterobacter shape. We have the Klebsiella. We have the enterobacter. Escherichia, Serratia, and Citrobacter. Again, we have kiss on cheeks, Klebsiella, Enterobacter, Escherichia, Serratia, and Citrobacter. Again, Klebsiella, Enterobacter, Escherichia, Serratia, and that of the Citrobacter. So you remember kiss on cheeks. And like those that are non-lactose fermenters, we also use this three culture media in order for this to be differentiated, these organisms to be differentiated. We have that McConkey agar wherein, if they are lactose fermenters, they will produce pink colonies. And for that Heia, usually this Klebsiella, Enterobacter, Escherichia, they are yellow colonies under the Heia. And also for the xylose lysine, the desoxycholate agar, this Klebsiella, Enterobacter, and Escherichia, they also produces yellow colonies. So both that of the Heia and that of the XLD, they produces yellow colonies. But for Klebsiella under the McConkey agar, they are usually mucoid, producing pink colonies. colonies. And for that enterobacter, they may be mucoid, and also they are pink colonies. And that of the Escherichia, it's not mucoid, but they are flat, that are dry pink colonies. So you remember that the Klebsiella, they are usually mucoid, producing colonies in the McConkey agar. That of the Enterobacter, they may be mucoid, but that of the Escherichia, which also produces pink colonies, they are usually dry pink colonies that are usually flat. And for that serratia, what is the unique feature of this under the McConkey agar is that they are red pigmented organism, especially if the agar is left at what temperature? It is usually at 25 degrees Celsius, or if this is left at room temperature. And that of the Citrobacter, what is unique about this lactose fermenting Enterobacteriaceae is they are regarded to be a late lactose fermenter, meaning that after 24 hours, they are considered non-lactose fermenters, but after 2 days or after 48 hours under this McConkey, they will be classified as lactose fermenters. So they are usually late lactose fermenters because they will only produce lactose, or they will only ferment lactose after how many hours? It's 48 hours. And for that serratia and Citrobacter under hectonenteric agar, they are usually colorless colonies. And that of the serratia under the XLD, they are usually yellow also or colorless. And for that Citrobacter under the XLD agar, they are usually red, it can be yellow, it can be colorless with or without black center. So that's it. Just remember, kiss on cheeks, it's very sweet. That's why you classify them as lactose fermenters, because you know that lactose, it's a type of sugar. And those kiss on cheeks, Klebsiella, Enterobacter, Escherichia, Serratia, and Citrobacter, kiss on cheeks is really sweet. That's why they are classified as lactose fermenters. Thank you guys for watching this video. I hope that you have learned something from this vlog number 3 for my educational category for the medical technology field. So you remember this mnemonics, and I hope that you like my video, and please subscribe if you are not yet a subscriber of my channel, and please share also this video para kumalat naman yung video ko. Thank you. And also you can comment on what are the topics you want me to make for another vlog. Thank you so much. Bye. Hello everyone, welcome back to my YouTube channel. It's me, Tala P. And for today's vlog, may hangar tayo dito. Hello everyone!